Here goes. Okay. Here it is.
Oh, they're already scapegoating COVID.
I know.
Or maybe they weren't. I didn't have time to read it.
They were.
They were. Of course.
Hello, everyone.
Oh, I can't hear.
I'm Shinya Takahashi.
Yeah, the volume is kind of wild.
Nintendo
Direct.
Hello, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide as well.
The Nintendo Switch system is now in its fifth
year. Yeah.
And many people around the world.
I was just gonna say I'm hopeful for Breath of the Wild news too, but now there's something that's not working.
All ages
and there we go.
All levels of gaming experience. Thank you all very much.
And Kylie's here.
We've been able to offer a wide variety of games on the system, not just from Nintendo, but also from our many development and publishing partners.
Brit right now?
I hope that each of you watching this Nintendo Direct will be able to find a game that suits your personal tastes.
And
today,
Jeff,
we have news on upcoming Nintendo Switch games.
Yeah, his hair is going crazy this
year. Selection of games releasing this year. We hope you
this
enjoy.
Guy.
The guy on the right?
Yeah, the guy on the
take
right.
A look at this video.
Oh, you did this thing! The other guy didn't do it very well. Oh! Ah, no, it's Smash. It's Smash.
Yeah,
they tricked us already.
It's too cinematic, anyways.
Wait, are they announcing Lion King for Smash? Oh! It's Tekken guy.
I don't even know who that is. Tekken?
It's Kazuya. Yeah, he's from Tekken 3, well, Tekken's in general.
My brother's been playing Tekken.
I hope that's not the only Smash announcement, because I feel like most people don't care about Tekken.
I want to see another anime sword character, to be honest.
I mean, that's true. At least it's not an anime sword character. Oh, who else are they announcing? They're announcing someone else.
Why is he just throwing these people into, like, a weird...
Oh, it's because that's what he does. He did that to his dad.
Oh, it's like an edgy guy.
Yeah, I should show you the video afterwards. I have not had problems, Jeff. It has been fine. Like, I've been... Every time they present, not every time, but multiple times, I stream it, and I've never had an issue. If you're wondering about, like, them, you know, not wanting any of their stuff online, they actually changed that. I believe it was, like, on the year the Switch launched, they changed their rules so that you were fine streaming or playing their games online, because they used to have it so you had to be signed up with them to even stream anything of theirs, but now... Now anyone can do it.
Oh, are you talking about the Nintendo Japan tweet?
Oh, did they? Say something?
Nintendo Japan tweeted today, like, don't co-stream.
Oh, really?
It was specific to that account, though. Like, region account.
So, hello.
Everyone I know is already co-streaming in here.
Of the Super Smash Brothers Ultimate game. Kazuya Mishima from the fighting
game
series
get banned forever.
Will join the battle. Surprise!
I saw an article.
I'll go over the details at a later date, so please sit tight. For today,
Kirby
though,
isn't dead. He can fly.
A short
Kirby
video to showcase Kazuya's moves in Super Smash Brothers Ultimate. Please take a look.
Kirby's fine.
So we're gonna get a okay. This is the presentation for the day.
That would be terrible if the entire presentation is just this guy. I mean, I love Sakurai, but like, you know, they start with... I feel like it was symbolic that the first person that this guy brings to the cliff is Ganon, because I think we're not gonna...
Yep,
I'm gonna be getting anything about Breath of the Wild.
No.
I used to care about, Brit said, I don't care about Super Smash Bros, to be honest. I used to care more about it, but, like, nowadays I don't really play it anymore. Like, I cared about it when I was in college.
This feels
more
like
than
Tekken.
Anything.
No, it's Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'll talk about the fighter more in a future presentation.
Oh, okay. He's not going
to go. We still have
it.
To record
yeah,
it first,
thank
actually.
God.
The air date is shown below. Please stay tuned.
Thank you, Mr. Sakurai.
You're welcome.
New fighter Kazuya will join the fight in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please look forward to seeing how Kazuya, who has experienced many harsh battles across the Tekken series, will fight in this game. All right, let's continue with our first batch of Nintendo Switch headlines.
A bunch of
oh yeah, and game. They said only Switch software, so they're not going to show any hardware.
Your choices matter in these emotional, supernatural tales.
Oh, I know what this is. We've already seen this today.
Yeah.
Or is it not? This is actually
looks
different.
Like it is different, but it looks exactly the same.
Yeah, I thought this was Life is Strange.
Yeah, me too.
Is it? It is.
Yeah, I get a variation or something. I don't know.
The Switch can't run the 3D advanced graphics of Life
it already is can't run the bland looking game, so we gotta.
Oh, now they're all together. They're all together.
Oh, it's just a collection or something.
Yeah, I think it's a collection. A fully animated Amori. Oh no, so it is actually coming. Okay. It's just coming to the Switch.
Gameplay footage not final. Uh-oh.
Oh yeah, no, this is cinematic. The game doesn't actually look like this. Jeff said,
Life is Strange.
For me,
True
this
Colors launches
may
on Nintendo Switch September 10th.
Be 35
and
minutes of
Life
stuff I don't care about, and 5 minutes
comes
get
to
me
Nintendo
pumped.
Switch later this year.
I'm worried. Like, I love E3
There's
presentations.
For everyone on the Nintendo Switch
there hasn't
system.
Been a good Nintendo Direct in like years. Or this, right?
Yeah.
You are Star-Lord.
This is coming.
Leading a legendary band of heroes for hire.
How is this
going to
run on the Switch?
Jump
like
on a
poo-poo.
Wild
it's
going to
be terrible.
Overwhelm opponents with Star-Lord.
It's going to be so bad.
And encounter iconic and
the Switch
Marvel
is so
characters.
Bad at running anything.
You'll call the shots for the unpredictable Guardians.
Like, I'm worried about this running.
You got this. Probably.
Yeah, it's gonna look like
Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy ever. Blasts onto Nintendo Switch October 26th. Worms everywhere! In this real-time arena-based shooter, you'll squish your invertebrate
yeah,
opponents.
Right. This is the game everyone wants to see.
Cross-platform combat, play in daily challenges, battle modes,
ooh, that frame
and seasonal
rate,
events to worm your way up the ranks.
I can't wait for the frame
plus,
rate on Guardians of the Galaxy.
Outfit, exclusive to the Nintendo Switch version.
Jeff says should run well on the new Switch though.
Launch,
single tier.
Spaceport Showdown launches with Worms Rumble.
I don't think that exists, Jeff.
Nintendo Switch, June
I think
23rd.
That's it.
Get a 25% discount when you pre-order the game starting today on Nintendo eShop.
Yeah, this it's running rough. I hope
the
they smooth it.
The fantastical realm of Orcanon awaits. As you explore this fully hand-painted world,
oh,
you'll
this
customize a team of demigods
from that same
devastating
developer that made like those that game with like the characters with the massive boobs and massive muscles.
Astria Ascending launches on Nintendo Switch
is that
September
like
30th.
A lot of games though.
No, but like, I mean,
yeah.
Massive.
Okay, I don't know what you're talking about.
Charming and quirky world of Two Point County. In the Wholesome Management Sim 2-Point Campus,
Wholesome Management
you'll build and run your very
sim?
Own university
what?
The way you want it.
Yeah, that's
lots
an interesting way of describing it, but
disposal.
I love 2-Point Hospital. It's a super fun sim
empire to the
if
next
you enjoy
level.
Sim stuff.
Enrollment for 2-Point Campus starts on Nintendo Switch next year.
I don't think I've played a sim game in my life.
Not even the Sims?
No.
A beloved series rolls into its
Sims.
20th anniversary this year.
Donkey Kong. Oh, it's Monkey Ball. Never mind. Yahoo! I mean, Monkey Ball's great. But they messed up the last time they released the game. Are they releasing all of them? They're releasing all the Monkey Balls! Give me the Monkey Balls! These games are great, though.
Couldn't this be a game that's on mobile?
It could, especially because the whole thing is that you're not controlling the monkey, you're controlling the tilt of the level. So it would be perfect for a phone because they have like the motion controls.
Yeah, no, I played one on the Wii. I don't remember which one.
Oh, the Wii one was the worst one.
played something on the Wii.
Yeah, no, they definitely had one on the Wii, but it was... Mania
rolls onto Nintendo Switch October 5th.
Monkey Ball's actually really good. So yeah, you tilt the level. It's like the Breath of the Wild ball puzzle that you tilt the level underneath. It's kind of that, but a game.
Of course you are.
Wait.
It's a superstar collection of Mario Party boards and minigames. Live it up on 5 classic boards from the Nintendo 64 era.
Are you kidding?
Birthday cake and Space Land.
Yes.
Each board is packed with zany events guaranteed to keep you on your toes.
They're like, we're not going to make a new Mario Party, but we're going to get the best of the old, and that's honestly way better than them making a new one.
And give facelifts? In hilarious over the top.
I'm all for this. I'm all for this.
Button controls. With 100 minigames from the Mario Party series catalog, you'll have a blast in this All-Star Fun Fest.
I am all for this.
A little party favor. All game modes work with online play.
Perfect. Okay, I was asking.
Solo, you can randomly match with other party goers worldwide.
I want to play Mario Party with people.
Save your progress mid-game.
You can save the progress mid-game. That's the biggest problem with the Super Mario Party. If someone drops out, they just, you know, the whole game ends. That's it. So like, if someone has a connection problem, boom, it's done. This fixes that. You know, classic Nintendo Online is not very good, but. This looks great.
Before we show this next trailer, I'd like to say one thing. Currently, we're working hard on the latest game in the Metroid Prime series, Metroid Prime 4.
Trilogy?
Which we previously announced.
Metroid Prime Trilogy?
But today, we'd like to introduce another new entry in the Metroid franchise.
I love Metroid, come on.
Please take a look.
It's all happening. It's real. Okay. I'm ready for this. Oh? Is this like a real sequel? Metroid 5! What? okay, this is... I know this is gonna be a 2D Metroid, but this has me pumped. I love the 2D Metroid so much. They're literally the best. Talk about Metroidvania and like people love Castlevania and the medieval style. I like the space style, and no one does it. Is it just called? Oh. They haven't released a proper sequel because Metroid Primes are prequels to the story. They haven't released a proper sequel to the story since 2002, I think. Oh, that looks cool that you can swipe him.
I mean, I would buy and play this just to say I played one, so...
I hope it's good, though. Otherwise, like, play one of the other ones because they're all fantastic.
Are they on the Switch, though?
No.
Exactly, Nintendo.
Oh, that's cool. You can, like, become a statue. Oh, look at all those new cool power-ups. I'm just a fanboy for this, though. Even if it were bad, I'd probably be like, ah! This is amazing. Tell me when. What if Mother Brain comes back as a robot? Wait, Mother Brain was kind of a robot already. Oh, they're gonna show footage after the presentation on the treehouse. It's coming out soon!
That was the trailer for the first new 2D Metroid game in roughly 19 years. The brand new years. Metroid Dread game.
So yeah, Fusion was the last one in the story.
This is a Metroid game with a new feel, showcasing a variety of threats that Samus will encounter.
So it seems to be... that's interesting. I wonder where they're going to go with this story, because Fusion left it on the interesting place.
On that same day, we'll also be releasing amiibo figures.
I like that robot
Samus.
Yeah, these are cool. Even Samus's new suit, it looks cool.
Well, the whole deal to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Looks like a gaunt. What are those? What's the word?
These familiar franchises are
I'm not sure.
on Nintendo Switch.
The mech stuff in Japan.
Get ready
Gundam?
To get down
yeah, Gundam
in the
mech.
Latest Just Dance game.
Is that what it is called?
Yeah.
That's what it looks like. Samus suit. Wasn't the old one just like an Iron Man suit or something?
No, there, it was a little bit different. It was more metallic. The reason is that in Fusion, a bunch of stuff happens and then she becomes the suit. She can't take it off anymore.
Just Dance 2022, okay. Launching on
Nintendo Switch. Is that plot device? Don't take it off or like.
So that Zero Suit Samus can't exist anymore.
Yeah.
No. It actually like I don't know. It's interesting. I don't want to spoil it because it's worth playing. Four players can
race together. But it's not. I'll never be able to play it. I don't because it's not on the Switch.
Just find a Game Boy. It's fine.
I don't. Nintendo Switch this fall. Why didn't Nintendo just release all the old ones in like preparation for the Doom Metroid? Huh? On Nintendo?
Well, it's good to see that everyone is pumped about the new Metroid 2. I love that we just ignored the whole Just Dance thing, because really, who?
Protect the Earth from an invasion
or
by
this.
Vegeta
this
and
looks
Nappa.
Awful.
Frieza, take a stand against the evil
So, like, you play through the anime?
Cell, battle the androids in a fight to the death.
Oh, dude. I don't watch Dragon Ball Z.
An epic showdown with the most fearsome foe.
It just doesn't look
Along
very
with the main
good.
Story, you can explore
Jeff
the
says,
vast world of
Have
Dragon
there been
Ball
other
Z.
Games after that? No,
hey,
there haven't
why not
been.
Help out the locals or collect ingredients.
But
for
yeah, I highly recommend playing Metroid Zero Mission, which is
too.
The remake of the first one.
There are lots of things to keep you busy.
Metroid Super Metroid.
The boss battle episodes, a new power awakens
well,
parts 1 and 2.
Metroid Zero
included.
Mission, Metroid 2
Dragon
on the 3DS.
Ball Z Kakarot. Plus, a new power
you
awakens.
You have all these things
again. Way onto Nintendo Switch
Super
September
Metroid,
24.
Which is 3, Metroid Fusion, which is 4,
Grab
and now Metroid
club and get ready to tee off.
And the Primes. The Primes are all prequels to any of the Metroid.
The Mario Golf Super Rush game launches soon. Here's a quick glimpse into each
yeah,
of the
it's
modes.
Fantastic. Zero Mission is really good.
Standard golf.
The biggest complaint
Take
people have about Metroid is Metroid Fusion is that it's very chatty. There's a lot of talking and dialogue, but the gameplay is still fantastic. Also, this I am pumped for this. Nice. This Speed I love Mario Golf, and now they re-added. So my favorite part of Mario sports games was that they had an RPG in them, and like you made your character and you played, and there was an actual story. And this is bringing it back, so I'm pumped for this.
Battle golf.
And they're adding a bunch of actually cool modes, like battle golf and like
capture three flags to
whatever
win.
It's called, where you are all have to like
golf adventure.
Run and do it all
Go
at the same time.
Go from rookie to pro with your Mii character. The golfing challenges that await may surprise you. And here's some news. Free updates are planned for future release, including additional courses
free
and
updates.
Playable characters.
Nintendo, still one of the only companies
the
that still
open.
Does free updates.
Set your tee time and get ready to ace those shots in Mario Golf Super Rush, swinging onto the Nintendo Switch system June 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop.
I've heard about Fusion Hover.
Ready
yeah, I
for
hope
the
so.
Ride of a lifetime?
This is the...
Welcome to the vast and
Breath of the Wild substitute
of
until we get Breath of the Wild 2.
So, this isn't
as a
Monster
in
Hunter
RPG
game?
Adventure,
it is, but this is like made
I mean,
in...
Right.
Your monster, a monster
it was,
companion.
It's made in the Breath of the Wild style, so it's
Gather
Monster Hunter, but it's not Monster, monster Hunter at all.
No, I mean, do you fight journey. Monsters?
You do.
Like, in but Monster Hunter style, or is it more
I don't know.
More docile.
But others may suddenly ambush you. To fight, you'll team up with your monstie and use
oh, is
weapons
it
and skills
based?
To overcome
this...
in turn-based battles. Win,
yeah,
and you'll
that's
be rewarded
not...
with their materials.
Well, I guess it's not very Zelda Breath of the Wild. Never mind.
Hey, is that an egg? You might be able to hatch a new monstie.
Like I say, an open-world Breath of the Wild Monster Hunter, no way that runs eggs. On the Switch.
Need more traveling
or
buddies?
They put the
Join
time
up with
in
friends
to make
for co-op
it up.
Multiplayer quests and battles.
I thought that like maybe it is going to be open Rider. World. It's just that
yeah.
you know the graphics are way less.
Monster Hunter
yeah.
Stories 2: Wings of Ruin soars
What's
onto
up?
Nintendo Switch July 9th.
So,
you can play the free demo on June 25th and carry over your save data to the full game.
Oh, save data transfer, Pogger.
Brit says, I so wish they would add turn-based company. Battles to Legend of Zelda. Interesting. I think that's a controversial take.
What do you mean? Who am I?
I would cry if that happens.
And it's finally ready, a brand new game from my company.
I don't have the patience for turn-based games.
You get to control me.
I love these.
Time to do this. Look at me go. What? Rats. Check out these.
What even is this?
It's WarioWare.
They have wonderful new talents.
What is this? This is very different.
Stick thing.
You have to play as an avatar?
Use the spinning, whatchamacallit. Ha! Nailed it.
Nintendo couldn't afford the rights to Wario, so.
What? I almost forgot some big news. Two people can play together at the same time.
Two people.
So nice. I love WarioWare. WarioWare is a blast.
Eh? Not nice. All right, you. Yes, you, the one watching this. Better get ready for some microgame mayhem.
It's like they got the mini games from Mario Party and then they made it even faster and chaotic.
Launches exclusively on the Nintendo Switch system September 10th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
What did Brit say? I wish you could play as other characters and have them join your team. Let's make a Legend of Zelda a little more like Final Fantasy game. You should play, what's it called?
There are new microgames.
A calamity game. Because you control multiple characters. It's not turn-based.
There's also a two-player
but you control
greatly expands the game.
The Hyrule Warriors game?
Yeah, Hyrule Warriors, the Age of Calamity, the one that's not just random. Hyrule Warriors is like there's a proper story to it.
It is a brawler though, I think.
Yeah, it is a brawler. Yeah, Hyrule Warriors, Age of Calamity.
As a high school student living in Tokyo, your life is fairly
Persona?
Long.
No, this is Tensei Megami Tensei.
Yeah.
But that reality is upended.
Maybe it'll happen. I was hoping for a new 2D Metroid. Yeah, maybe. Maybe we're gonna get all of our dreams.
What is this?
Another Tokyo exists. A post-apocalyptic world.
Yeah, this is
where
in Megami Tensei
and demons reside. 5.
I think it's going to be a timed exclusive on the Switch, and it's like a big deal. This is the series that Persona spun off of.
Gaining the power to fight.
Yeah, I've not played one of them.
What lies ahead in this alternate realm?
I know that Shin Megami Tensei 3 got released on everything recently.
The world
PC,
is now transformed
Switch.
Into a sprawling demon-infested
and this is turn-based.
Wasteland.
This is turn-based. So.
Okay, so...
So you're not gonna play it?
No, I was gonna say I take it back. Turn-based and Persona games, I love Persona games.
Oh, okay. So you might love this one because they've... A lot of the things are very similar.
It's the only game I like that's turn-based is the Persona series.
You can perform in a combo will increase.
Because they share a lot of similarities gameplay-wise. Even like some of the characters, like the pixie and like stuff like that.
Yeah.
You may be able to recruit them via negotiations.
It already looks almost identical.
Which begin when you open a conversation with them.
The difference is that it has more to do with the creatures you collect, the demons you collect, and you. It's kind of like Pokemon, but for grown-ups, I guess.
Will become a powerful ally.
But it's very Persona-y too.
By rejecting a demon's request,
I will definitely play this. Motivated, it looks like,
and join you as an ally. Demons that do join will fight alongside you and grow stronger.
I mean, you can do that in Persona too, but it's more like their Persona.
By fusing demon allies,
you don't actually have them as in their form. Their
the newly fused demons' innate abilities will vary, granting you a
Yeah, Britt, I am actually curious too why you love turn-based so much. Because it's very curious. Like you would even want a Zelda game that, you know, because I feel that
challenge
Zelda has always been like action RPG. Where I think it would be cool for a variation, but like to have a mainline, to me, I still prefer it. But I'm curious to know like where that comes from.
Shin Megami Tensei 5
also, I love that they're showing
Switch November 12th.
that they're gonna actually show a lot of the interesting games afterwards too, which is good because they're just like keeping it quick and keeping it brief during the presentation instead of 20 minutes on something I don't care.
This is the newest game in the series. Please look forward to future updates. Let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
This isn't
celebrate
good.
10 years of Danganronpa.
They're in releasing
despair.
A new Danganronpa?
Testing. Mic check 1, 2. This is a test of the school.
I haven't played any of these.
Yeah, they're like murder mysteries.
I want to, but time commitment is too much for me. Danganronpa
series are coming to Nintendo Switch.
Oh, is it the whole thing? Oh no, this is.
I am this school.
Monokuma, the self-proclaimed school headmaster, has trapped you and other high school students in a game of.
I love how high schoolers in any
death.
Anime look like they're 30.
The only way out of the school and the.
Yeah, no,
game
it's all anime.
The
second
the
they put
students.
An age on it, it doesn't make any
and
sense
so
anymore.
Like. Girls that look 5 years old are 200, and then guys that look 30 are 12.
You're the culprit, aren't you?
Yep.
Tanya, I had no idea. They probably moved the body there.
Use the evidence you've gathered to refute contradictions and find the guilty party.
Sneak attack. No,
wrong. Oh, Jeff is waiting for that big announcement.
Okay.
What big announcement?
Any like massive announcement?
Well, that's what I'm hoping, but I don't know.
I'm pretty happy already because my expectations are so low. My expectations were just like, show me Splatoon 3, and I think that's gonna be it.
Who's the strongest of them all?
Oh, Splatoon sucks.
Did you see that? Oh, I kind of want to go back. There was like a ripped
as a physical exclusive
girl, but like
Nintendo
she looked at, like a massive dude.
All four games will also be individually available on Nintendo eShop.
Oh.
We hope you're not
Ghost Frame or
ghosts.
Whatever it's called.
Familiar? Is this
Fatal Frame? Yeah, Fatal Frame.
Is this new or old?
I don't know. I think this is new.
In this horror adventure game, you'll uncover the mysteries surrounding the ethereal but deadly Mount Hikami, believed to be at the center of many disappearances. Ghosts frequent this mountain. Your only defense is a camera that can repel and cast them out.
I love that
camera.
Whoever makes this game, they've been with Nintendo for so long. They keep releasing these games exclusively on Nintendo consoles.
Features various protagonists. Letting you experience the game from different
they're
perspectives.
Supposed to be like good
new costumes and photo modes
games.
Are included in this version.
No, I'm not too into camera
Hikami
games,
but... and stay alive.
It's Pokemon Fatal Snap
Maiden
but
of
for
Black
Go.
Water creeps onto Nintendo Switch this year. These games and DLC are coming soon. Some even today.
Oh, what? Oh,
your war is not over. Raise hell in the first campaign expansion for Doom Eternal, The Ancient Gods Part 1.
This one was interesting because apparently it runs better than any of the previous id Software games on Switch. Like, it actually runs okay.
As you eliminate Hell's newest threats.
Because, like, they've apparently made their new engine terrain. So that it will work with the Switch okay.
The fate of the cosmos is in your hands.
That's cool.
So, which is crazy to me, like,
id
Tech, their
Switch later
engine is, like, so crazy, because it looks so good on the high end, but it can still run super well now on the low end.
Remastered in HD.
Good job, id Software
skate
people.
To era-defining jams as the legendary Tony Hawk and a roster of new and returning pros. Take your sessions
is this
on
a
the
remake?
All the original game modes, and compete locally or
I
online
this
to
game
show off
I
your tricks against
younger.
Other skaters. Drop into Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2,
yes!
Launching on Nintendo Switch June 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop.
I love those. And the soundtracks.
After 4,000 years, Sateki, the Witch Queen, has risen from the dead. And only one group of heroes can stop her. The Strange Brigade. In this thrilling adventure, you'll blast through an army of mummified monstrosities while solving puzzles in booby-trapped dungeons.
Jeff,
go it alone
I think she
or
is.
Team up with other daring adventurers
is.
In local Death wireless
said,
co-op and
Britt,
online
are you
play.
Searching your soul about why you love RPG
Expect
games
the unexpected
turn-based?
When Strange Brigade launches on
silence.
Nintendo Switch later today.
Yeah, I don't even know what that
it's
was.
It's a new adventure of cosmic proportions.
We already saw this.
Yeah.
Mario
Next.
And his friends will team up with the rabbits once again to restore order to the galaxy. Our
yeah, no, the Tony Hawk games are pretty soon. I'm excited.
The universe into chaos.
If I had unlimited money, I would already get like 10 things that they showed on
Rabbit
this presentation.
Rosalina joins them. Wait, is she bored already? Explore planets filled with quirky residents and even quirkier secrets.
I'm a fan of the Rosalina Rabbit.
And in this fresh take on the tactical genre,
not in a weird way,
our heroes can run freely around the battlefield, creating new strategic
well, when you say that.
So aim for victory with a little help from your friends.
I just think she's funny.
Wait, who's that? Well, one thing.
And they
certain,
added like an edgy
this is
anime
gonna be
rabbit.
One heck of a galactic adventure. Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope launches into space or onto Nintendo Switch next year.
The Mario and Rabbids are actually pretty good strategy games, and they're changing it up. They're making an action strategy with this one. No, no. They're bringing back Advance Wars? That's crazy. People have been asking for the last Advance Wars was 2004, I believe. This is like for strategy games from Nintendo. It was this and what's the famous one? Fire Emblem. And they completely stopped making these because they were just focusing on Fire Emblem. It was like the same studio who made both. It was actually really cool to see what they're making.
Memorable characters and vibrant gameplay are in store as you lead the commanding officers to victory.
I love strategy, turn-based strategy games like this.
Play the first two Advance Wars campaigns in Advance Wars 1 plus 2 Reboot Camp. Marching on to Nintendo Switch this holiday.
Ooh, okay.
Pre-orders
okay.
begin today on Nintendo eShop.
Ooh.
How is everything? All right. This next segment will be our last announcement of the day.
Okay.
Please,
I was gonna read what
look.
You said, Britt, but last announcement of the day. Oh, it's Age of Calamity.
I don't care.
It's Age of Calamity. They tricked us. They tricked us.
No way. That's the end.
They messed up. This is the final announcement. Get out of here.
The barely 30 FPS brawler you have. I mean.
Yeah, I know. This one goes like down to the 10 FPS when with performance. Aww. They didn't go Breath of the Wild 2.
Yeah.
No, they showed some cool things, but yeah, none of like the really big ones. Oh, you can play Zelda on the bike.
Oh my god, DLC out the
There's so much here. DLC on the screen right now. Get it away.
Yeah. What am I? Oh, hey. I'm not going to talk about Zelda.
Producer of the Legend of Zelda series. What you've just seen is a trailer for
he's
the
just
first
here to say that he's
DLC
not showing anything
for the
again.
Warriors Age of Calamity expansion pass from Koei
no
Tecmo
way,
Games.
Dude.
Yes, we know.
It will follow Link and his allies through more battles that took place 100 years prior to the events of The Legend of Zelda Breath
no
of the
way.
Wild.
Oh, Kaya says hello
you'll look
to you.
To it.
Who?
Kaya.
I have a few more
oh, Kaya.
Things to
hey,
share
Kaya.
With you all today.
Been a long time.
We'll begin with The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD game. Which
get out of here.
Month.
This man's a troll.
You'll immerse yourself
I
in
know.
The role of Link.
He's like, we're
going to
talk about more Zelda.
They could have gotten anyone to do what he's talking about.
Or by playing in handheld mode, wielding
right?
the sword via
and...
flicking the stick
yep.
and button-only controls.
I don't care about flicking. Get out of here.
This game the oldest era in The Legend of Zelda series, the story of how it all began. What is the origin of the Master Sword?
Hi, Kaya.
Why did a woman named Zelda become the legend for future generations?
Why did the woman
These
named Zelda
be
become
unraveled in this game? We hope you're looking forward to The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD.
I'm more looking forward to something else here.
Next up.
Next up.
Wait.
No, stop,
Here's
you troll.
You might like. This is a Game & Watch system that lets you play three games in the Legend of Zelda series. This year, the original Legend of Zelda game reaches its 35th anniversary. While we don't have any campaigns or other Nintendo Switch games planned, we've been working on
we don't have any other Switch games planned
to help mark the occasion and reflect fondly on the earliest days of the Legend of Zelda.
What? We canceled Breath of the Wild 2, by the way.
We're just not going to tell you ever either.
Zelda 2: The Adventure of Link, and the Game Boy version of The Legend of Zelda: Link's Awakening game, as well as a special version
of I do
Game
have the
S&P
one.
Vermin, starring Link as the playable character. So that's four games on one system, from longer Legend of Zelda games to the pick-up-and-play game Vermin. In addition,
these are good games, but, you know,
we've added a playable clock based on The Legend of Zelda, and an interactive timer themed after Zelda 2, The Adventure
of Link. You
know. Yeah.
Oh, look, Doritos.
You can play with both of them by taking control of Link.
Yeah, I actually really like the...
We hope you'll enjoy playing this
Game
& Watch system.
Game & Watch, but yeah.
And wherever
I'm not buying that. The thing's probably gonna cost a lot, too.
What Brit said.
All right, here's the last thing we have to show you.
Last thing!
This is the sequel to The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild.
Two years
have passed since we first announced this game, and we've been unable to share anything with you in that time. However, development has been steadily progressing. For today, we've prepared some new footage to show a bit more of the game.
New footage!
Yes!
Let's go!
Oh my god.
It's like 3 seconds of footage, and it ends.
Yes,
oh, he becomes evil? He becomes Ganon?
Shadow Link?
Shadow Link? Please. I want it.
No.
Zelda's dead. Okay. I'm with it.
Oh. What am I looking at? It's good.
What is this? He's half corrupted. What?
Yeah.
What? This looks crazy!
No way.
What in the... He can stop time! He can reverse time! He can dig!
Dig dog!
What is happening? So it's going to be partially the same map, partially a sky map? I'm so confused.
Yeah, it was a bit obtuse, but it looked cool. 2022? Obviously Christmas, probably. But...
Yeah, like, they showed the same map, but then there's those sky areas, and they look plentiful.
This time around, the setting for the adventure has been expanded to include the skies above Hyrule. We'd like to ask you to wait a bit longer. We're aiming for a 2022 release,
Amen.
So I hope you'll look forward to it.
Ha. Huh.
How was that? That's all for this Nintendo Direct. We are diligently continuing development on a number of other games we didn't show today. I hope you'll continue looking forward to what's in store on Nintendo Switch. Thank you for watching.
So, is the original map just going to be like just the same game or what?
No, I think it's going to be different. I think they're going to change the map up somewhat. Yeah. Like, it's still the same place, but like different things will have happened. Like, maybe meteors fell into different parts and destroyed certain parts. You know how, like, this is going to sound horrible. You know how, like, Fortnite maps change every season.
Hi, I'm Doug Bowser from Nintendo of America, and I'm here with
hopefully
Nate
better
Bittler,
than that,
who leads our Treehouse team.
Here, I'll lower Doug Bowser here. We're all about it seems like you're gonna have that map that's gonna be essentially the same map, but a little bit different. And then you're gonna have the sky as well. Because I think they're not going to change the layout of it, because I think that's, you know,
it's a direct
sequel.
I mean,
yeah, well, it would be a little weird if the whole universe changed, but I guess...
But I think it will be different. I think they'll, like, have moved things and added things and changed things. It's going to be the same layout, but different stuff on the map, if that makes
sense. If it was identical, that would just be weird.
Yeah, if it's identical, then, you know...
That would feel like DLC, I feel like.
Yeah, I'll just throw my Switch out of the window. But no, that looked good. That looked good. It looked interesting. It looks like more Breath of the Wild with some cool new abilities, like time stopping and digging.
He lost his arm. He's Sekiro.
Yeah, he became Sekiro Boy. Yeah, I but like completely honestly, I legitimately doubt it's going to be the same exact map. I don't think that will be the case.
I'm waiting for them to release a trailer on YouTube so I can rewatch it. They're not doing it.
Yeah. We should rewatch it. I'm gonna check it out though.
Yeah, I don't see one up yet anywhere.
Nintendo. Oh, actually, we can just watch any of these. And just rewind, because YouTube, you can rewind the stream.
I'm watching on Twitch.
Yeah, I just went to YouTube right now. Because I saw
that. Oh, right there. We do have
our treehouse team. Here we go. Alright. Do you want me to just share the screen so that we're on the same part?
Yeah, that might be easier.
Alright.
Shut on.
Okay. Here we go. Let me share my screen with you. Start virtual camera. And turn camera on. There you go. All right. Let me stop the music. So, yeah, I'm going to be pausing here. So we got to see Ganon there. And I'm guessing he's cursing Link. This is a trailer analysis now.
He's losing his, it's like in Metal, he's got the arm that's possessed now or something.
Yeah, just like in Metal Gear. Oh.
Yeah, exactly. Confirmed, yeah. Metal Gear coming back.
Breath of the Wild 2, made by Kojima.
I would be down
for that. I would be down for that too.
That would be very weird.
Okay, so Zelda falls into the abyss.
Zelda's useless and always... Oh my god.
I wish this would have been a great opportunity for them to let us play as both Link and Zelda.
I agree. I want a game where Zelda has even the tiniest bit of agency in anything.
Have you played Wind Waker?
No, I haven't played any Zelda.
Oh, you should play Wind Waker. I'm not going to say anything. This already looks interesting. I wonder if they're going to have sky loss, because how in the world are you going to fly that high up from the sky peak, from like the sky islands? I think they're bringing, not sky loft, what are they called? Loft wings. The little birdies from Skyward Sword.
He almost looks like he's wearing something Grecian, like his outfit.
Yeah, it looks Greek. I don't know. And look at his arm. You can definitely see that he has like the Revolver Ocelot corruption on it. Yeah, and his hair is all crazy. But yeah, he looks like Icarus kind of vibe.
Yeah, let's get Scuffed Link up. I like it.
And then you have like these new types of robots that you're gonna fight. Let's go back to it. Bro. So I'm guessing these are gonna be like Sky Guardians or whatever.
Yeah.
And I like this too, that like now the rock guys, they have little guys on top of them.
So maybe like this is just a change up of the base stuff.
Yeah.
Right there.
Mm-hmm. You get new abilities on your arm. So this looks interesting because he's not only freezing it, there's a path that he's making.
Yep.
So like I wonder how you're gonna get to decide the path of that. Oh, that was interesting.
He has a flamethrower?
Like,
it looks like a flamethrower on his arm. So yeah, he has arm attachments or something.
But this is on the other arm, so I'm guessing this is something he just picks up. He can just pick up stuff that does this kind of stuff.
Yeah. Got a little thing coming out of a rock. I have no idea what that enemy is, but...
Yeah, Jeff, I think
Yeah, this is a bit confusing. This is kind of like, how is this going to work? Are you planning the path? Like, does it just show a path?
He is just shooting it back the way it came,
I wonder if that's it. It just rewinds the time for this, because everything else is moving normally. And then that's the only thing that's, like, going backwards. So maybe it is a time thing. So it's just, you're rewinding the ball while everything else is staying the same.
And that would make sense. It's a little bit like stasis, but a playoff of it, I guess.
This is interesting, though. The water going back. So it seems like there is going to be some time play in some sort, like, that you control, I'm guessing. Yeah. And then here it goes into him digging, which I guess could be, like, the way he travels. He can, like, point at some place and he just goes straight towards it like an arrow. And just digs into it.
A sucky arm. Maybe he points his
like this too. It makes me think of Rossetti from Animal Crossing, just popping up like that. But this is cool. So, you can see the old map underneath.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you can see that mushroom area.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. That's the only thing I'm concerned about. If this is all we get, not. I mean, it's still cool, but if, like, what we're seeing, it's very obvious the lower map, the original map, is much more intensive than these little islands. I don't know.
But yeah, that's why I think they're going to change up the original map. Like, again, still same location, but, like, it's going to have different things on the map all over the place.
I wonder if they're undoing the lore of you beating Gant. Like, because you... I'm trying to remember how the game ends. Don't you win?
Yeah, you beat the Calamity Ganon guy, spoilers, and then you win. Well, Zelda spoilers.
So I guess, they go back into the castle? And
so I think that's Ganondorf. I think that's, like, a previous version of Ganon. Because Ganon, just like Link and Zelda, keep coming back in the story because of what happens in Skyward Sword. If you haven't played Skyward Sword, that has the lore.
Well, I will be playing that.
The lore for you. But, so there's a reason why they keep coming back, and so that was probably, like, an old Ganon from a previous time that died. You know, the evil Ganon part of him became Calamity Ganon in the current timeline, but then they went back and found old Ganon.
Like, his old, like, body's entombed underneath.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. Well, it did have, I mean, that, what the original announcement trailer looked like they were doing some weird,
I'll pull, like, that up too once we finish this. I'll pull up the original announcement trailer. Let's see, what have you guys been saying? Oh no, Britt, your internet went out. It could be, Britt says maybe there is a lot of new map that they just haven't been showing yet. That is true. That could be a thing.
Yeah,
and they're just not showing it. Let's see. Yeah, it would be the biggest bummer not to have an entire new map to explore. That's going to definitely be interesting, too, because I think one of the biggest joys in Breath of the Wild for me was exploring the map, just straight up walking around, discovering new things. That's why I think everything is going to have to be moved around and shuffled if they're going to be reusing the same map.
But in a good way, not in a, like, cheap
way. Yeah, not in a cheap way, like, oh, yeah, we put the Korok 2 miles away now. You go over there. No, like it has to be different.
Like those procedurally generated games. Like, oh, lol, it's different, kind of, but it's not. It's just
One thing, if you played Breath of the Wild, like, and went to the northeast of the map where they have that random tower in the fall looking area that you don't do anything in, I think that's what they could do. There's so many areas in the Breath of the Wild map that just don't get used. It would be interesting if they change up the map and then all these areas that were kind of, like, not important for the game become important for the game. And now you're actually, it changes the structure of the game because you're having to go to these places you hadn't had anything to do before. Or something
true,
like that.
But I know that depending on how you play the
Breath of the Wild, you can beat it in like 3 hours or something.
Yeah, I mean, you can beat it in like 10 minutes.
Minus the speed run.
Okay. Like,
if you do it like the four beasts, it's still like you only go to like a tiny bit of
No, it's crazy. You don't really explore the game at all if you just do what you have to do.
Yeah.
900 new Korok seeds.
That would not be good. No.
Just to discover, did you ever find out what the end prize was? Like what they, because they in the end, I don't think this is a spoiler. It's just funny. They're like you know, you hand the Korok seeds to the guy, and he actually tells you they are poop. And they're like, droppings all along. Yeah, and it's like, oh.
Literally going around the map gathering shit. So.
Literally.
Yeah.
Yeah, has to. Ah, that's such a great game. It just brings back so many good memories. Let's see. This is going to be really interesting, Jeff says. What all gets new attention and doesn't? Yeah, for sure. Because I don't think they're going to make use of the full map, because they didn't in the first one, and I don't think that they're going to do that in the new one. Yeah. Britt says, I just don't know. I explored the heck out of the first map. That if Breath of the Wild 2 is the same exact map, I'm afraid I'm going to lose interest fairly quickly. Yeah, I was like that too. I explored everything before I finished the game. Because for some reason, for me, some people can like finish the game and then explore. I can't do that. The moment I finish the game, do the final boss, I lose interest in the game for some reason. So yeah, I don't go back to it.
I agree.
But yeah, so... But that's why I think that they're going to do something. They can't just keep it the exact same map. Because I think it's going to be the same issue for so many people. Here's the thing they haven't mentioned, though. They haven't mentioned if the weapons are breakable.
I mean, they better not break, but I don't know. I feel like they won't change it.
I think they're going to still be breakable.
Three hits, your metal sword just snaps into 1,000 pieces.
It's even worse now. You have to change your weapons every time you use it. I would really like... If they, you know, even if they kept the breakable weapons, if you could fix them so that if you find a weapon you like, you can keep it. The way I think it could work, because they want you to always be finding new weapons and stuff, and I think they could keep that. The way I think it could work is like in Fallout 3 in New Vegas, where you find more of the same type of weapon and you use that same type of weapon to fix the one you have.
Yeah.
So that you can, you know, you maintain it, and it'll never be good as good as a new one, like the durability or whatever, but you can maintain it. Britt says, I'm sure y'all have seen the Breath of the Wild parody videos, but some of them are so hilarious. Yes, I love them. We were watching this the other day, but Terminal Montage's stuff, he has a great one on Breath of the Wild. Jeff says, I didn't mind breakable weapons personally, although I can see why some were annoyed. I personally wasn't super annoyed by it, but I can definitely see the
well,
the pain.
It gets exponentially more annoying if you go to Master Mode.
Yeah.
It breaks instantly.
That's the thing with Master Mode, I just don't think it was balanced properly, because the beginning is so hard, but then once you get good weapons, then it's easy.
Yeah.
So.
I played it, the playthrough I played the whole thing, I did normal. I messed around in Master Mode after.
Same. But yeah, just to go back to some things that they said, Britt said, beating the final boss is like closure. Yeah, exactly. Like, to me, in my brain, the story is done. I don't want to keep going in the world where, like, I finish the story. It makes no sense.
You got that classic reload the save to before the end, and it's weird.
Yeah, but it just doesn't feel right. It's just like, eh.
Yeah.
But, yeah. And she also says, I mean, you could upgrade your gear at Great Fairies, so why not let you upgrade your weapons to where it's indestructible? That's actually a good one. So, like, they're breakable, but you can pick a weapon, and it's probably, like, really expensive. But if you really like a weapon, you can make it so it's not breakable. Because
even the Master Sword broke. Like, hello?
Yeah, it broke, like, it fixed after 15 minutes, but even the relics, the weapons of, like, the legends or whatever they were called, I forgot, they broke, yep. And they were gone forever. Like, that's why I never used any of their weapons, because it's like, it's these legendary weapons. I don't want to lose them forever and never see them again. So then I never used them. And oh yeah, and they had the motorcycle. I completely forgot that the motorcycle is in this game.
Yeah, I never collected that.
Yeah, I never got to that part because you had to finish the DLC. And I got like a decent amount through the DLC, but then I stopped. And the DLC is hard to get back into because it's like a series of challenges that get harder and harder. So if you drop the game and pick it back up where you were in the challenge, then it's like extremely hard and you're just like, oh, can't really do it. All right, I'm going to keep going through the trailer here. Yeah, there's the Mario Galaxy kind of situation happening. Castle being pulled from the ground. And then we get a look at the map. So even here, the area in front of the map. So this is the town, right? But this didn't exist, I don't think, in the map.
Not
like this mountainy rocky area close to the castle. I don't think this existed.
I don't remember, to be honest. The stuff on the left all looks pretty familiar.
Yeah, like this, the town looks familiar, but even then I think there were more things. I know it was all broken and stuff, but this looks a little bit different layout wise of what it was. Not exactly sure. There's still some towers, but I remember there being more broken buildings in the middle. But I don't see any of that. There was something familiar to that, to the rocks. There were some rocks nearby, but I don't know what angle it's looking at. So I think over here, I'll use my, over here is where you come from if you come straight from the beginning of the game, and you'd like go like this to the castle. So this would be to the right of it, if you're looking from this perspective of the, where you come, it's like to the right. So yeah, east. Mm-hmm. I guess if you, yes, east, the actual cardinal direction instead of to the right. And I'm guessing you won't, or maybe you will still be able to access the castle and go finish the game in 10 minutes. Because you'll be able to fly around. I love seeing speedrunners though just run as Naked Link to the castle though. Yeah, there we go. Let me find the teaser. Breath of the Wild 2. Here we go. Let's see. Yeah, there's a shrine in those rocks. Okay. I wonder if the Great Plateau will still be a thing. I wonder. I'm noticing there's no towers in the background, so you can't see the divine beast. Oh, interesting. So, yeah, towers. I wonder what they're going to do with towers, because, yeah, I didn't see any towers. And there's no divine beast. So I wonder what happens to them. Because otherwise you can just laser the beginning of the game, calls in the beasts, lasers them down, game is done. It's like the Far Cry 4 ending that you can get at the beginning of the game by just sitting at the beginning.
Oh, right, yeah.
Okay. I thought these were really cool in the original trailer, like these little lines that transform into text. Never pay attention to that. I wonder if that like is a reference to one of the original ones. I'm trying to see, because obviously that's Ganon, and he's that's someone with.
I mean, it might just be that mural that they have in the game during one of the cutscenes. Yeah, so we get to ride elephants or something.
Or that's just in the intro.
Thank you. That's him right there.
Yeah, that's
body or something.
Oh, interesting. So the hand, maybe that's the hand that Link is gonna get. Right there. Yeah, so that's Ganon. I guess he's being... This makes me think of Ocarina of Time Ganon, because... Or does he die with a sword to the head? I know that he dies with a sword to the head in Wind Waker. But if it's a sword to the chest, maybe this is like the Ganon from Ocarina. Yeah, this feels way a lot more like a cutscene. I don't think you'll be able to play this part. Because, like, even the... Actually, that's a good thing to check if the medallion matches any of the other Ganons. Ganondorf. Because he has... They're different in all the games, so it could be... The closest one is this one. Because this one is like a little winged... Or maybe... Which one is this from? This is from Hyrule Warriors. No, that's a little bit different from all of them. Although... I don't know. It's closest, I think, to the... Twilight Princess one. But... Hello! Yeah, there's a lot of quick succession. So, okay. Maybe I feel like that is right before Zelda falls that we got to see now when we see for half a second him trying to capture falling. Then the hand holds Link. I think that's it, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... Oh no, this is Zelda... Or is this Link? No, that's Link. So I think they're both falling, but the hand saves. This is an interesting image. Because it's still holding him in the actual thing, but the shadow is...
What's going on there?
Yeah. Oh, so it could be Zelda because she's wearing. Yeah. I don't know. He kind of looks more like Twilight Princess. Yeah. But it still looks different. It looks more like the ancient beasts. What are they called? The one that go and then they laser you.
Was it the Guardians?
The Guardians, like that type of technology on his forehead. So I guess he always has like something on his forehead, but this design is more like that sort of thing, more technology than any of the other Ganons.
It's just another zombie Ganon.
It just becomes a zombie Ganon. It'd be terrible. Oh, hello, Kyle! Oh, yeah. But yeah, it looks interesting.